Here at six, Gary Woodland for birdie and a share of the lead. The 35-year-old from Topeka, Kansas, and a three-time PGA Tour winner.
Gary Woodland for birdie.
Look at this thing cut across the hole. See, the higher you get, or the closer you get towards that right fringe, the more the break plays into the putt. So we've seen everybody putt from more underneath the hole. That was more to the right of the hole as you're looking at it, and consequently it broke more than he read.
Get on this difficult par four.
The most intimidating looking second shot here at Pebble Beach. Over the big cliffs. Oh, what a shot for Woodland. Leaves it under the hole.
Saw that approach from Gary Woodland. This for a share of the lead. And you run off the eighth green.
Only the fourth birdie here today, Shane. He's hit every fairway, and that was only his 10th putt in 8 holes.
Gary Woodland at 9.
Poor tee shot sabotaged Woodland, but a nice putt, and he'll be really pleased to walk over to that 10th tee.
Now Gary Woodland to save par here at the 12th. His putt could save.
17th, Woodland for par just a moment ago.
Oh yeah, ducked it in the right edge.
Go to Gary Woodland here at the 18th, his third.
Well, this is a long shot. Now the wind picking up. It's into the wind. Hard to get it back up there. But pretty good for Woodland. That bunker's down pretty deep.
Go to the 18th and Gary Woodland for a birdie.
Ideal place to putt from. Can't be much break. And join the list of people that miss it to the right on 18.
Still, that will be his best start in the U.S. Open in 9 tries in this championship for Gary Woodland.
It's about as good a chance as you'll ever see here at 12.
Rolled the well yesterday. He's now 3 back.
This will be outside the right a little bit. You got to give it a hit. It's up the hill.
Five iron here for Gary. So right at the hole if it carries.
Oh, it did. Chance going through that thick rough. We'll have that to get to 6 under par.
Going to face that stretch where there are some gettable holes. Here he is for birdie at 1, his 10th hole, and he's 6 under.
Here he comes, I'm telling you, and that was a hard putt. Played about 2.5 or so feet of break, barely touched it.
Gary Woodland, his second shot at 2. 1 back coming off a birdie at 1.
Well, he's just plopping it on to every green, Joe. He's only missed 1 of the first 11. That is going to be nice.
That has been the difference for Gary Woodland here at Pebble Beach this week.
He's got 2 simple holes coming up, 6 and 7, reachable par 5, and then just a sand wedge, and then 2 beast of a holes to close at 8 and 9.
Birdied here yesterday. And a nice kick. He's gone 23 consecutive holes without a bogey. Second shot for Gary Woodland at 6.
He scorched it. Look at this. Gary Woodland, he'll have that for eagle in a 2-shot lead. What a shot. Which he's had to take advantage of. He knew when he turned that this could happen.
Tap in birdie coming. To climb into the lead all by himself.
Appears to be on a good line. I think when you're hearing the caddies and the players say 95, 94, that's what's where they're trying to land.
Really good effort there for Woodland.
Pretty well played hole, Brad. He watched Ricky Fowler, at least he saw where Ricky Fowler was over the green. He wanted no part of that.
No chance.
In his ninth U.S. Open. Best finish was a tie for 23rd back at Congressional in 2011 when it was wet.
Eight, Woodland to save par.
Treacherous putt here at Pebble Beach. Look how far out he aimed, to some 3 feet. And Gary Woodland, another one putt. Showing him the Justin Rose Club here for getting it up and down.
This could be really, really good, and it is. That is a tough tee shot. It's cold out there right now, and oh boy, right into a divot.
They're hitting it out of a divot in the fairway.
Probably the slowest putt he's seen today.
Oh yeah! Round of 65 and leading by two.
Good solid par. This with the toe side. That's a heck of a shot. Not everybody's got that. There's a lot of risk too, Joe, if he mishit that. Got tatered right there. That was good all the way.
Only one bogey all week for Gary Woodland, 29.
This is a bomb.
Took that 3 wood, Curtis, and hooked it right around there. This favorable right to left against win for these players, making it easier to turn into three.
From 184, this is 64 degree wedge.
That's beautiful control of the spin there, not to draw it back too much, and a chance for birdie again for Woodland.
Lightly back up the hill.
And a quick weather update, guys. Everybody's taking clothes off here, or out of wear anyway. It's warming up a little bit. Sun is trying to peek through at times. It's pleasant.
Solid start.
I think every other week of his life, Gary Woodland would hit a 3 wood off this tee shot. Not today. Oh boy. That sank down there. You can only see 3/4 of the golf ball. Choked down on that one a little bit, drove it in.
What a good shot that was.
Oh boy, he spun it left, kicking. I sometimes think, Curtis, you get those, it makes you focus more, doesn't it?
And Gary first to double digits.
That is 32 holes in a row without a bogey and out of the bunker.
His power, his strength, his ability to crush off the tee, and he's going with a long iron here. And I like it. Mickelson hit a couple of irons on the green earlier. Woodland will have no trouble.
And a little heavy, Curtis. Good shot.
Iron off the tee. Second shot up in the bunker. Third shot to here for birdie at six.
No body English needed on that one, Joe. Dead center.
And just rolling right along.
Catapulting bounce right there, hole high.
Here's Woodland for par at seven. Good report that Matt Kuchar made his bogey.
He has looked rock solid, Gary Woodland.
Yes. Boy, he looks so comfortable. Every shot on a string. Just got a real low key demeanor.
Now Woodland at eight to save par. And there it is. 34 holes without a bogey. That streak will end here at the eighth.
It's more of that first putt there. It was a big error. That's a tough putt to try to make down the hill there. Little slider. Big misread on the first one off the fringe. Koepka drops back to 10 under par, and Justin Rose picks two shots up here.
They responded pretty nicely.
Woodland at nine for birdie.
I hit a poor putt on eight. That wasn't a whole lot better.
Lind for his par.
Solid. Wind on the right side kind of helping him.
You're a stick, Gary.
There it is, right at the middle of the bunkers. Beautiful tee shot.
Safely into the fairway at this 499-yard par four.
It'd be wise to hit this out to the right just a little. Super. That's going to be putting right back up the hill and away from the ocean. It'll be slow. Just really slow. Not his best effort, but that's no harm, no foul. 10th is a difficult hole. You don't think of it as a birdie hole. You just want to get out of there with a par. Just what he did.
Under for the week.
And Woodland with driver.
An aggressive play.
Well, we saw Dustin Johnson do that yesterday and questioned, why do you need it? Woodland did that without any effort. A confidence to have driver on this hole. Shane Bacon said earlier, hardest hole to hit in regulation, and even more spin. This is going to get close. What a shot from our leader, Gary Woodland. That putt to get to 11 under par. Maybe they grow at a little different speed.
Three shot lead for Gary Woodland.
ITA!
Come on, you've got to be kidding me.
Take that, field. What a great save for Gary Woodland. Another chip in.
Talk about how great these guys hit it, but it's that touch around the greens that separates. Yep. Another beauty. And confidently hold again.
One inch on that ball rolling back, not rolling back. He could have made a double there.
Boy, well, look at this zinger. Beautifully played. Brad, I made the mistake back there. I said 13 and 15. It was 12 and 15 that he'll think about possibly if he wins.
Well, no, but Curtis, but you're
he
right.
He also saved at 13 as well. So.
Pulls it back a little bit. A lot.
Team putts through 15 holes today for Justin Rose. And Woodland in with his par. And these two lead the field today.
Watch out!
Talked to Butch Harmon this morning, his instructor, and Butch said he was swinging so good I didn't have to say anything to him. Would you like to have that just once?
We'll go to 16 and Woodland second.
Got to get it far enough to the right. Winds out of the right. Big slope in the green from right to left.
Yeah, beautiful shot. That's the most we've seen two lines that far apart.
Stress-free par.
Yeah, I gotta say that graphic's pretty good. I haven't seen many putts outside of those things go in, that's for sure. That was a wide cone.
Okay, good shot.
Out to the right a little bit. Just fine.
That's to be expected, really. Never took his eyes off the flag stick. Beautiful layup, Curtis. Did go around that tree to the right.
It's not an easy layup.
Justin Rose, when he went to the claw grip, changed his life. Gary Woodland also much improved on and around the greens.
No cracks in his game today.
Good shot.
Not much forward. Birdie, as has Oosthuizen. Here's Woodland for birdie at one.
That's a little nervy start there on the green for Woodland. Love those shoes. It's going to be the hardest round of Gary Woodland's life.
That's a nice answer by Woodland.
After a drive of 325. That from 198.
He likes to cut the ball. He just doesn't want to overcook it here. And a great shot by Gary Woodland.
Justin Rose tied at the top. Here is Woodland at two for birdie.
It's a big putt. Yes. Nice to take the lid off early and to birdie one of the hardest holes on the course, the hardest one today.
Rock shot. It's a real good indication of how Gary Woodland can feel here. You see him like to fade it like he did off the first two holes, and here a nice draw, three wood way down there.
From 96 yards, has to be careful coming up a little bit short right, severe downslope.
He likes it. Look at this. Woodland not backing down at all.
What a start for the 54 hole leader, Gary Woodland.
There's a beautiful picture of Gary Woodland's ball flight, high, lowest scoring on the front nine all week today.
What a good touch.
Yeah, that's a great touch, Curtis. And through three rounds, there's no player out here in this field that's made more feet of putts than Gary Woodland, over 350 feet. Second, right next to him is Justin Rose at 302 feet. Looming right behind him is Brooks Koepka.
You want to guard against a big miss left here. Any kind of miss left, and that's a beauty. If he could have walked up and placed it there, he would have.
Lynn for birdie, our leader by two.
Good confident putt for Koepka there. Disappointing par.
Woodland taps in his par.
He's going with a long iron here. He did that yesterday. That's a bullet. Let's see if it runs out.
And it's also way back, Paul. Way back.
Second shot for Gary Woodland at the par 5 sixth.
Boy, it takes a lot of courage to kick that ball out there to the right and bring it back. What a good shot. thinned it.
Yeah, Paul came in really low and hot.
Yeah, he thinned it off that tight lie, Curtis.
Koepka parred number six, the par five, and Gary Woodland the same.
And his first missed green of this Sunday. That will be left for his par. He has been a par saving machine at Pebble Beach.
Good iron for Woodland. I really think that putt he made on seven is a real statement for Gary. Chance to drop a shot, make his first bogey.
Back at the eighth and Woodland.
That's a big eight iron.
Perfect club there, Curtis.
Red line's the high line. If you hit it slowly, see which one he elects. Goes up high.
Well judged.
Just got it outside that red line by a second.
That's such a cool graphic.
It's a beautiful one.
Here at nine, Gary Woodland, our leader now by three.
It's got to be. Oh, it's a duck hook. Oh.
Thanks, man. If his feet slipped, they did not.
That's just a defensive play with this hazard down the entire right side of this fairway.
Fantastic.
Trying to avoid making his third bogey of the championship from over 5 feet this week. It's to the right all the way. Things just get a little tighter.
The lead is down to two.
Put that tee shot on nine behind him. Stripes it here off the 10th. That is perfect.
His lead is down to one.
Pressure is really getting amped up on Gary Woodland now. He's won three times, Joe. He knows what it feels like to try to win. He'd be pretty happy with that one. Not even that clown behind him could distract Gary Woodland at this point. Some guy waving a sign back there. I don't know what that's all about. But.
I love this play. It's a big show of confidence. But again, just like Rose, he's going to miss it into the right rough. That was a hard swing
way up in the air.
Are you kidding me? That's the
unbelievable
best.
There.
Curtis, there are not many players that could do that shot.
And more power to get this out
And Shane, it's really hard to control the distance your ball goes when you have that much speed in the open-faced club.
All things considered, real solid par for Gary Woodland.
Boy, that settled in some deep rough, and he's going to have to go over that bunker, then down the hill.
Great shot. That's just sometimes you have to take your medicine.
Well, it landed right on the front of the green from him, and impossible.
We mentioned Woodland's run of two bogeys in this championship when he arrived at the ninth. He has now made two bogeys over his last four holes.
That is no good. The hole's on the right.
Way to the right.
Big bunker protecting it, Curtis, and might get a break there. He's got a little bit of a lie, but still no chance to get that close. That is something special.
Here's Woodland at 13.
That is some kind of par, Joe, from where he drove it.
He is even par for this final round and will hold there through 13.
That looked like a much smoother, much slower transition. And just like anybody else under pressure, the swing can tend to get short, Joe. And
going out the front left bunker. Carried it, carried it.
What a shot that is. Is blasted 263 yards to the hole. That's a 255 yard carry uphill, and I gotta tell you, it's cold out there. That way you'll never dump it. That's okay, not great, got a little work left.
What a birdie.
Boy, he just calmly stepped up there and rolled that in.
Just 220, 230 off the tee. That's another one.
He loves it. And Zing and Curtis, I can't help but thinking, in 1992, Tom Kite playing the final day, took a 3-wood out on 14. Mike Carrick, his caddy, made him go because he knew he could get at that front bunker. I'm surprised that we didn't see a fade here like this, letting the wind help it. Can't get all the way to the shelf. Needs to go another foot.
And just about gets it. One more look at that. How close to a three-shot lead.
Yes, yeah, Shane, and it races away a little bit here at the end. But what a good putt. Solid as it can be right there, right up the hill. Didn't look like 3.5 feet. Felt like 10.5 feet for Woodland.
Curtis, I think the fact that he doesn't have to hit a driver these last three of the last four holes, obviously not 17, but he can hit the stinger right there like he did on 15, and he can do it on 18 if he's got a lead.
Good contact, good looking shot.
Oh, beautiful play by Woodland. He actually had a shot out of a divot on number four on Friday. Hit that same sort of shot. Well, that stayed in the map the whole time. Hard to hit it up that hill.
And just what he needed to do. Simple par at 16 for Woodland.
Right side of the green.
That is not a good shot at all. And he's probably going to have to pitch that ball off the putting green. Sounded great. Oh, look at the shot.
Zing, we talked about off the tee how that was maybe the biggest swing and shot of his life.
And clip that ball, no divot whatsoever. Sweep the leg, Gary! And watch it check right there.
Well done, Gary.
Beautifully played. Another well played layup.
Safely on in three. Got it! A major champion, Gary Woodland, has won the U.S. Open.